I think a lot of you guys know that karate was born in Okinawa and later brought to mainland Japan by the hands of Gijin Funakoshi, Cho Kimotobu, and many other senseis. However, did you guys know that Japan itself influenced the Okinawan karate way before karate even came to Tokyo? Learn more in this video. Hi guys, I'm Yusuke, a karate coach in Japan, and thank you so much for checking out today's video. Today's key phrase is Ogasawara Reiho. Let's start with the video. So I think the common understanding of how karate was born in Okinawa was that due to its geography, Okinawa had a relationship between various cultures such as China and various countries in Southeast Asia. Receiving such influence, Okinawa cultivated their own martial arts called karate, which was later introduced to the Japanese in the 1920s. And I think people usually understand that karate was totally a new martial art for the Japanese back then. However, let me shine a light on Ogasawara Reiho, which is a Japanese etiquette followed by the samurais, which might have influenced karate in Okinawa. Let's start by understanding the word reigi. Reigi means manners or to be considerate of others. You express this spirit through saho or etiquette in English. The spirit and the method are set, making reiho combining two words or etiquette ho. Ogasawara Ryu Reiho, or Reiho in the Ogasawara style, dates back to the Muromachi period, which was in between 1336 to 1573. That was way before karate was introduced to Japan. It was the Reiho form for Japanese archery, horsemanship, military practices, etc. So basically for the samurai society as a whole. Therefore, it was not just for martial arts, but also intertwined with almost any movement throughout your daily life. Let's take a look at this actual video of Ogasawara Reiho way of walking and going up and down. So starting from how they bow and walk, we look at the suriyashi that they're performing and the way they sit down. They don't break down their posture. And look at the gradual movement and that gradual opening technique. And see how well they're in control of their body. I think you can literally see the posture part, the etiquette part of karate in this movement. So like I mentioned, it was horse riding first, and the suriyashi, look at the suriyashi, very nice and very similar, right, to how we do our footwork too. We don't kick the ground, we slide the way they bow. The posture does not break. You don't tilt forward, back, or to the side. You're in full control of the body at all times. And see how well their weight is controlled. And you can see that the weight is rather on the toes and sliding. The heels are a little bit popped up. That gradual down. Yeah, everything is continuous. It's not like you load the weight on one leg and you jump. And if you guys are interested in Japanese theatrical movements too, like kabuki and no, you can see these movements right in those. So seeing those movements, don't you think they're very similar to karate? So how is this related to karate in Okinawa? Well, surprisingly, the elites of Ryukyu Kingdom, which was their former name before getting conquered by the Japanese, were practicing Ogasawara Ryu Reiho. Since a lot of those elites practiced karate as a form to defend themselves, I believe the Japanese Reiho had an effect on karate. I think that is why our bow, footwork, control of the center of gravity, posture, and etc. looks extremely similar to the Ogasawara Reiho. What do you guys think? Personally, I believe these are heavily influenced. So let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. If you disagree, agree with me, let me know. If you'd like to see more of this historical kind of videos, please check these out. And if you'd like to learn karate with these cultural backgrounds, then why not check out my online group lesson from down here. I will see you guys in the next video.